many people, Patrick, might think, might label you as being an eccentric. Would you object to that?
Not in the slightest. I'm sure it's perfectly true.
Is it a condition that you approve of?
Yes, I think it probably is. It's awfully difficult to tell, you know. I mean, does one nut think another nut is a nut or not? It's an interesting psychological point. There's something there, you know, for the psychiatrist to work out. And no one can be nuttier than they are.
Psychiatrists?
Of course, yes.
Well, what's wrong with them?
What isn't wrong with them, as far as I can see? I have never yet met a psychiatrist who isn't nuttier than several fruit cakes. I may have been unlucky, you understand, but that's merely I can only speak as I find.
But how do you feel, Patrick, how do you feel about other real eccentrics? I mean, you are, I would say, you're genuine, mild English eccentric and delightful for it, and God bless you for it. There aren't enough of you around. But what about the real eccentrics, the flat earthers and the people like that? I mean, how do you feel about
that? I have the very greatest sympathy for them, I may say. And after all, don't forget, many, many years ago, there was a man named Copernicus. And Copernicus said, the sun does not go round the earth goes round the sun. And everyone said he was a crank. But, of course, the Earth does go round the sun, at least I think it does. How can one tell? Yes, I have every great sympathy for what I call the independent thinker. And I say I would hate to see them vanish from the Earth. Oh, the flat-earthers, the hollow-globers, the cold-sunners, the astrologers, the flying sorcerers. I think it's a jolly good thing.
But Patrick, the fact of the matter is that the Earth is not flat.
How do you know? Can you prove to me that the Earth is not flat? Go on, try. I challenge you. Prove to me that the Earth is not flat.
Well, I'll tell you what, mate. If it's flat, an awful lot of people have been wrong for an awful long time.
Are you going to take my challenge?
Well, of course. Of course, you know it's not flat.
Well, why not?
But it's not.
What's
wrong? I've seen pictures of it.
From where?
From satellites.
Refraction of light. Next question, please.
What about people who say they've seen Martians and people like that?
Interesting point there. Do you remember, long, long time ago, 1938, when there was a misleading broadcast of H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds over in America, and people thought the Earth had been invaded by Martians. And people, you know, actually rang up to say they'd seen the Martians and their heat rays and their fighting machines.
Yes.
Very interesting indeed. And I'm sure this accounts for quite a lot of flying saucers.
Yes, you mean that people would like to imagine that they've seen them.
Well, I don't know whether you really want to imagine Martians with heat rays. I certainly don't. But they certainly thought they'd seen them.
Mm.
No, it's just true.
Do you think that there's any likelihood, though, given that we accept ourselves as being an intelligent race, do you think that there's any likelihood of being an intelligent race other than us in the universe?
In the universe, somewhere at this very moment, there is a television studio, and there's somebody like you, and somebody not, I hope, too unlike me, and they are talking exactly as you and I are talking.
Probably
here.
Asking the same questions.
Almost certainly asking the same questions. But of course, they are a jolly long way away, and I don't think they're going to come and see us tonight. At least, I rather hope they would, you know.
Do you really believe that?
Yes, I do.
You do.